Incremental greetings, welcome to Pressure Lightning. I'm William Palau, also known as William Palace. Today I want to share with you the Toolkit and Mercy. You may have used this, but here you have criteria. So instead of using random or reverse or whatever, or keeping the theme, you can customize it. Now the question is, okay, you have these themes overly complex. You have up to 5 parameters, and those parameters have percentage, which you can move up to 11 tiers, from 0 to 10. But what's the use of that? You can look at the documentation of SuperMemo, but I will use a simpler approach, a heuristic approach. Long story short is, don't focus that much on the percentage, because the percentage is always 100% overall. So you move, if I move here, you will notice now it's 43%. Priority, it's 43%. As I'm increasing this, the other elements, parameters, this is decreasing, right? It may happen, oh, if I put everything at maximum, what will happen is that everything will be 20%, right? And voila, 20%, 1/5 roll. What happened with the investment? I put all the others at maximum now. Investment is 2%. It cannot go lower than that. The reason for that is to protect the scenario that investment means that what you work at more will be prioritized. So all of the things you have investment that will be zero repetitions, zero lapses, and so on will become zero. To avoid that, you have at least one protection of 2%. Now, moving on. So the settings will be depending on your actual need. For instance, you will be using priority if you have been using the priority queue constantly from day one and so on, and you have so many outstanding topics that you want to reschedule them. Usually, I won't do that because you already have it. So, yes, you won't finish the outstanding queue, but the auto-postpone and the priorities are for that. So you don't actually need to use the mercy. It's just the psychological factor of seeing to zero every day, the only difference. So I don't have an issue with not reaching an empty outstanding queue, so here I won't use it ever, my personal opinion. Then lateness is okay. This is useful is if you want to focus on how long have been outstanding. So you may have items of different intervals. Let's say you have one item of 1 week interval, but has been outstanding for a month. It's not the same as having one outstanding item that has 1 month interval, but it's been outstanding only for a week. So you will be using lateness criterion if you want to preserve the retention rate. So you want to forget less as possible. So you start for what has been auto postpone longer. If you come from Anki, that will be relative overdueness. I'm not that sure if in SuperMemo is treated relatively or absolutely. I'm not 100% sure about that, but more or less will be closer to relative overdueness. Then investment. Yes, it is useful because while you put on more time, you need more repetitions, more lapses, and so on, you will prioritize that. And all the other items, elements that perhaps will be higher priority, but you only need one repetition or the automatic repetition and that's it, will be pushed further, will be postponed. So you have, let's say, 2000 topics. You will get the topics you invested already some time on them. So you need extracts, or you have to split them, and so on, right? So even though you will be filtering, prioritizing the items that are less likely to be forgotten, it's, I think, the most high entropy, because you already spent some time on them. So if you already spend more time on them, it's for a reason, right? If you are free learning, that will be high entropy. And if you are from using SuperMemo for a school, that will be, I guess, material for an exam. So you will have to do it anyways. Moving on, easiness. Here again, you may be familiar with that on Anki, the isness of a card, right? That by default is 250%, and depends on your grade, if you fail or succeed and so on, it increases or decreases, right? More or less same as in Super Memo. Here, the isness of an element will be how long the interval is, how many times you lapse that element, and so on. So you can set this option if you really want to. For instance, what I did with some months ago, that I haven't had any time at all. I was working full-time with many things that I only had like 5 minutes to spend on Super Memo. So I only focused on 10 minutes of the standing queue. That's it. But what you could do is that if you are very short in time, focus on what's easiest. So you are pushing the maximum quantity of topics or elements per time. In any other scenario, there's no really need for that, because the quicker you go, the more quantity you're sacrificing. And then recency. Recency is how recent it is. Let's put on one example. Is I import lots of stuff of chemistry, right? It's about what I'm studying and so on, so I really need to cover that. But later on is, now I discovered other fields of psychology, stoicism, linguistics. Wow, now that's very high entropy. So now the chemistry, it's not that it has lowered the priority or the entropy, it's that now I'm aware of something that is even higher entropy than before. So now the chemistry will be a second tier or a third tier. If that's the case, I will be pushing that. So if I use recency as a criterion, I will focus on the most recent stuff I did. So in that case, all the chemistry will be pushed out, postponed, and I will get items and topics of stoicism, psychology, and so on that are very high entropy now, today. And on top of that, you can mix up. It's okay, let me do, in that case, recency, some priority. But on top of that, there are some topics that are extremely long because are from a book. So I also want to include investment to get topics that I already did lots of extracts and so on. So overall, my conclusion is that you can simplify to not using all five criterions. And also don't look at the person that is just, for instance, is, half investment, that will be too much. So first investment, almost everything recency and priority, almost half. And that's it. So it's not 50%, 25 and 25. Investment, you don't have to tier zero. That's why visually it doesn't match as you will expect. Also, keep in mind the limitations that I'm not an expert on that. I have used Mercy for myself, so I am significantly biased. But I only wanted to share heuristics that simplify this, use it when really needed, as minimum as possible, because the consequences, the outcome, perhaps will be hidden until a couple of years. There will be no undo in a couple of years' time. Hope this seem useful, some insights. The purpose of this video is so you lose the fear of losing the mercy. Do a backup before doing that, especially if it's your first time. Nothing more to add today. Hope this has been useful. Please let me know if you have experienced the mercy, for the good and for the bad.